Okay, so welcome back. In this class, we are going to look at some very basic text editing or text formatting using WPS Office Suite. So you can see that, like I've explained earlier, the document, we are right now in the WPS document portion. So the first thing you need to do is to save this document. So to save a document, you can come all the way to File over here. Once you're on the File, you can come to Save As. Okay, and you can define the location where you want to save it. For example, I want to save it in this location, desktop, and I have this WPS document, and I can just come over here, give my document a name. For example, I can say text formatting in WPS, and then I can save it in this section one. For example, it's just an example. So you have saved your WPS Word document, and you can see the name that you've given it. And you can start by doing some very basic text editing. So to write a text, you can go ahead and start writing. You can type by the keyboard. You can just you can type anything. As you hit the return key or the enter key, you are going to change to another line, and you can go ahead and write anything accordingly. Alternatively, you can go to any portion or anywhere you have any document. You can copy and bring it in over here and paste it. For example, I have this document. I have this text that I have generated in ChatGPT. I can just come over here and just highlight some portion of it. For example, from this introduction, I can just select and come down up to maybe here and say up to this point, right click and say copy. And I can come back to my WPS, create another line, for example, with the return key. And you can go ahead and paste in directly with Ctrl V, or alternatively, this is going to paste in with the format that it has came in with. We can come over here, click on this, and you can say keep text only. These are different formats that you can paste document on. You can match the current formats that you are working on in this particular document, or you can keep text only. That's the one I always prefer, to paste the text without any kind of formatting as it is. Okay, so you can see this is the text only, or you can come down and say matching the current format. If it's going to match the current format, then it's going to come in with this haphazard nature. But then you are free to always come over here and do formatted text the way you copy it from the ChatGPT, for example. But alternatively, and the best way is to keep text only, which is going to keep only the text without any kind of formatting. So this is how to copy and paste and how to write anything. And if you want to edit any portion of the text, you can just navigate with your mouse and just click anywhere, and you can add document, or like you can add any text, or you can delete with the delete key on your keyboard. It's very easy to do that. Or you can highlight by just double clicking within the text. You can click double click to select a word, or you can triple click. Okay, with triple click, you can select an entire paragraph, and you can go ahead and copy it and paste it somewhere. Or you can select an entire paragraph and just delete it, because you can do anything you want. The pasting also, you have the option over here. You can do the same pasting options that we've explained. You could do paste special, or you can set default pasting from here, or you can do the three that we've explained. So this is how to bring in text and how to write text in WPS. Another thing I want to show you is basic editing in text. For example, for you to do any kind of editing within text, all you need is to highlight that text by selecting it and selecting the entire thing within that text. You can just click anywhere and drag to select the text. You can come over here. You have different kind of text editing features, like you can change the font style, different kind of font style. And as you hover over the font, you'll be able to see that the effect is changing on the text that you are having over there. Okay, you can see the font that you have selected is being reflected in the text that we've highlighted. Okay, so you can just go ahead, you can change the font style, and you can change the size. Okay, over here you can increase or decrease the size of the text that you've highlighted as well. So if you've highlighted this text and you come to sizing over here, you can increase or decrease the size also. As it is increasing, you can see the preview on the text that you've highlighted. Okay, so right now I think you can keep it here. and still selected that particular text, you can bold it, you can italize it, you can underline it as you so wish, and you can see it's bolded, it's italized, and it's underlined. These are just very basic changes or features that you can access. You can strike through if you have the option, if you want the option to strike through. Did a single strike through, you can strike through just like when you are editing something, you've edited or you've deleted all this, or you don't want this to in the document. And you can do double striking also if you want. Strike through, is it a single one, or emphasis mark? You can create emphasis mark if you're interested. Or you can do a subscript or superscript. Okay, this is superscript and this is subscript. If you have something like you are writing an equation, later I will show you in detail how to write an equation. So instead of x squared, you can just write x2, and with this you are free to make it a superscript by taking it to be x squared. You can see now you've taken it to the top, or you can do subscript by bringing it to the bottom, just like so. You now bring it to x2, not x1, and you have the option to select any text as well. And you can change the different kind of word art. You can change the coloration and make it look like this, or you can change you can put in shadow effect on the text you have selected, or you can put in a reflection effect if you want to add reflection, or glow effect. These are features that you can add, especially when you are dealing with headlines or headings, or you want to deal with specific characters for poster creation or the about. And then you can select any document, any part of the text. You can change the color of the text by just coming here. You can select different kind of coloration, and you can go ahead and change it to maybe red color. This is it. Or you can change it to any color, maybe green color or this color. Okay, so you can see the color has been changed. And if you want to change the background of this, then you can come over here. This is for background color. You can change the background color of that particular text. You can see you now change the background color accordingly, just like that. Okay, and if you want to remove, you can always come over here and say no color, and it's going to remove the background color as well. Okay, so you can see it. So it's very easy to play around with the text over here. You can, this is eraser if you want to clear formatting in any text. Okay, so you can select the text something like this, and you want to clear all the formattings, you can just click, and you can see it is back to the way it was when it was pasted. And if you want to play around with the caps, you can change the case, or you can do enclosed character or character border. You want to create character border or phonetic guide. Let's say you want to change the case of this, you are free to change it to sentence case or lowercase or uppercase. You can do or toggle case between upper and lowercase. Let's say we want to change everything to uppercase. With just one click, everything is going to be converted to uppercase. You can see everything has been done. Okay, so if you want to do character shading, then you can come over here. Alternatively, if you want to increase the size of any text that you've selected, you can use these two features. The first one is to increase, make it bigger, and the second one is to make it smaller. You can use both of them to increase or decrease the sizing. Okay, so this brings us to the end of this class on basic text editing in WPS Office Suite. In our next class, we're going to look at paragraphing formatting, okay, where we are going to have the option to use all of these features like the numberings, the page numberings, the paragraphing numberings, the alignments, and different kind of features. I'm going to show you in detail how to use all these. So until next time, thanks for watching, and I look forward to seeing you in the next class.